Hello, my name is Leo from TL Lab. Today I will talk about the Gadget. This year we mark 70th anniversary of the Gadget. Now you will hear a part of John Donne's sonnet, and later you will realize what meaning it has for this presentation. Butter my heart, three-personed God, for you as yet but knock, breathe, shine and seek to mend, that I may rise and stand, overthrow me and bend. Your force to break, blow, burn, and make me new. Manhattan Project was a research and development project that produced the first atomic bombs during World War II. And this map represents main sites for uranium production in Manhattan Project. In 1938, German scientists created first nuclear fission reaction by bombarding uranium nucleus with neutrons, causing instability between uranium atoms. Here you can see fission in uranium. Fission process is a process in which nucleus of an atom splits into smaller parts when it is bombarded with neutrons and loses its mass through release of kinetic energy, also releasing few new neutrons, causing new fission processes. And then German scientists opened Pandora's box. Prominent Hungarian-American scientist Leo Szilard wrote letters to US President Roosevelt and German physicist Albert Einstein to aware them of the possibility that Germany made first nuclear weapon. So there was a possibility to make a small bomb that would have a destructive power to destroy a whole city. On October 11, 1939, President Roosevelt responded to letters from Szilard and Einstein and formed Advisory Committee on Uranium. And about 2 years later, on December 7, 1941, Japan attacked Pearl Harbor for the first time. And the next day, December 8, US entered the war and President Roosevelt approved production of nuclear weapon. After many researches, scientists Leo Szilard and Enrico Fermi made first nuclear reactor called Chicago Pile 1, and you can see it here. They made it on a squash court beneath football stadium at University of Chicago. They wanted to demonstrate that it can be harnessed by sustained chain reaction in uranium. And they proved that that fission reaction can be used to make an atomic bomb. In November 1942, General Leslie Groves purchased 59,000 acres in Oak Ridge in Tennessee to be a main site for uranium production in the US. To grow the industry and to head up the installation, General Groves gave a place of director to J.R. Oppenheimer, excellent physics professor and theoretical physicist. And then Oppenheimer drew Hans Bethe, Enrico Fermi and Edward Teller directly from university. And then theoretical scientists began process to determine how much uranium-235 is needed to make an atomic bomb. And they said to Groves, it can be some X amount of uranium-235, but also 10 times more or 10 times less. On December 28, 1942, President Roosevelt approved additional $500 million for Manhattan Project, with main priority to build massive industrial facilities to produce uranium. And then Oppenheimer and his team of physicists doubled the amount of uranium-235 to be adequate to achieve critical mass for sustained chain reaction to 200 kilograms. And here you can see uranium in flasks. General Groves wanted to have an atomic bomb ready to use in a war, so he notified contractors that had 6 months to build a massive electromagnetic calutron designed by Ernest Lawrence at University of Berkeley in California. Calutron is a mass spectrometer that is used to separate uranium-235 from uranium-238. The sample vaporizes and turns into gas, and then it is bombarded with high-energy electrons causing the sample components become positively charged ions. And that ions are then accelerated by current fields and subsequently deflected by magnetic fields, ultimately colliding with the plate, causing measurable electric current. And one more interesting fact, due to the wartime shortage of copper, they used thousands of tons of silver borrowed from US Treasury to make coils of electromagnets for Kellutron. You can see here that Kellutron. General Groves wanted to recruit the people, as many as he could, to work for him in the Oak Ridge in uranium production. Then came about 75,000 people to work and live there. Groves had creative means to recruit them by putting the ads like, "We can't tell you what you'll be doing in the ridge, but there will be steak every night on the table." And instructions for the workers were like, "If anybody asks you what you are doing in the ridge, tell them that you are doing light bulbs or holes for the donuts." And here you can see some of the other ads like that. Meanwhile, in Los Alamos, that was one of the main sites in uranium production in Manhattan Project, design work was underway to design the Gadget. The Gadget was a code name for the first atomic bomb, and you can see it here. The first design of atomic bomb was a gun design, and you can see it here. Inside the bomb is a cannon that fires a piece of radioactive fuel into another at the speed of 3,000 feet per second. These two pieces are two pieces of subcritical mass that have to be connected into one critical mass fast enough to prevent spontaneously emitted neutrons from melting the fuel, causing the bomb to fizzle rather than explode. And here you can see five kinds of atomic bomb design, and in each of them is critical mass divided into two or more subcritical masses. By the late 1944, it was produced enough uranium-235 to make the first uranium atomic bomb, and it was called Little Boy. It was 10 feet long and had 10,000 pounds. But military strategists feared that it will be needed more than one bomb like this and that there is no more time to make it. So scientists changed the design of atomic bomb to reach new level. And the new man-made element, plutonium, was gaining a favor as new possible radioactive fuel. Plutonium is produced by irradiating uranium in nuclear reactors. And they made the plutonium implosion device called Fat Man, and you can see it here. On April 12, 1945, US President Roosevelt died, bringing his Vice President Harry Truman at his place. Secrecy about the Manhattan Project has been so tight that Truman was not privy to the bomb developments, so he had to be briefed very extensively during his first weeks in office. And less than a month later, Germany surrendered in Europe, and General Alfred Jodl signed their surrender terms. But Japan did not surrender, so US decided to continue with the project. The code name for the test of the first atomic bomb was Trinity. Trinity had a goal to test nuclear weapon to defend US, especially during World War II. The name Trinity was given by Julius Robert Oppenheimer, theoretical physicist, after idea of his favorite poet, John Donne, an English poet of 17th century. And part of his Holy Sonnet 14 you heard at the beginning of presentation. And this sonnet talks about the paradox that God destroys all in order to renew the world. So by Trinity test, the world entered the atomic age. The Gadget was hoisted on the steel tower, 100 feet high, And that height would give a better indication how the bomb would behave when it would be dropped from a bomber and would generate less nuclear fallout. And some scientists feared that during the explosion, the whole atmosphere will be ignited and the whole world destroyed. And here you can see that steel tower. Trinity test was on July 16, 1945 at 5:30 a.m. in New Mexico at Alamogordo Test Range in Jornada del Muerto Journey of Death Desert. There was an intense flash followed by tremendous shock wave and sudden heat wave and also ball of fire that extended 40,000 feet and had a punch of explosion equivalent to the explosion of 20,000 tons of TNT. And the steel tower, where the gadget was hoisted on, completely vaporized, and desert sand melted and turned into glass in the radius of 800 yards. So, after successful Trinity test, US decided to throw little boy and fat man on Japanese cities, and then was finished the World War II. But the atomic age has just begun. From year to year, it is developing and improving nuclear weapon and provoking an ominous fate of the people. Here you can see an obelisk that stands today at the Trinity site as a memorial. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something from this presentation. Please support us with subscribing to our channel.